Good evening. My name is Andy Beatles, and I am the instructor of the Civil Engineering and Architecture program at the Southern Indiana Career and Technical Center. Many of you may ask, hey, what do you do in a Civil Engineering Architecture course? Well, we study and primarily focus on building design and areas around buildings. The civil engineering part, we get into things like surveying, hydrology. We go outside, we actually learn to practice surveying and set up the survey equipment, take some points. We bring them back in, we create 3D models of survey areas. Along with that, we then look at how water flows around the site, what we do to get excess water away from the site, and how we actually bring water to the site if we need to. Along with the surveying and the civil engineering side, what we also do is we focus on the building shell itself. That's the actual shell of the building. There we look at how floor plans are developed, how we do design documents so that we can build a building. Along with that building, we also look at the design elements. We look at spacing, what goes in rooms, what doesn't go in rooms, how big rooms should be, what materials are in rooms. For example, what we put down for the carpeting, what we paint the walls. How does that reflect within the space of the room? In our 2 years that a person is here in that program, they can focus on everything from a residential structure to commercial structure. Along with focusing on these things, we also go and we dive deep into job-related skills and abilities and employability skills. So you learn to write resumes. You learn to see what colleges offer engineering and architecture. Along with all of that, we also get down to simple things like how you greet people for a meeting, how you write emails appropriately, and how you send those emails. So it's a vast, diverse, but focused area around civil engineering and architecture here at the Southern Indiana Career and Technical Center. Now, some of the things that you'll learn as far as hands-on skills. We spend a lot of time in the lab on computers, and in doing that, we actually use multiple pieces of software, and today I'd like to point out a couple. So over here, we've got a student who is actually using AutoCAD. We use all of the latest version of software. With that software, we can design and build our blueprints, along with going through and designing the different types of documentation that we can use in our building process. So if you look over, you can see that she's going through. We start off drawing simple mechanical parts so that we understand that software, and then we move into the architectural side of the drawing and the build process. So that's one piece of software you use. All the software that we use here at the Career Center is industry standard. It's also up to date. So she's using 2021 AutoCAD currently. Along with this, we use another piece of software that's gonna be located back here. She is using our 3D software called Autodesk Rivet. Autodesk Rivet allows us to build our building in 3D so we can tell a more complete story, but it also creates documentation. So you can tell that there's a big difference just in how you manipulate and move around in that software. So if you take a look, you can see that her building is here in 3D. It's a commercial structure that she's currently working on, an office complex. She's going through the design process of doing that, learning that software as she goes. Along with that, the ability to do the 3D stuff gives us another unique ability, and that is once we get to a certain point in the 3D process, we can actually come back here and we use our virtual reality equipment so that we can walk through and look at all the aspects of the design. So if you notice up on this screen, what's happening is he can actually go through the building and walk through the building that has been designed. Right now he's trying to kind of locate, he's looking at that exterior space and walking out onto the land property. All right, so he could turn around physically and he could then see the building there, so he can either walk around in that space in this area, or he can actually just highlight a certain thing. So it's a matter of taking it from an initial concept to a finished design or finished product. And along with that, we may also build prototype models along the way. So we do that in our prototype model lab. We can break down components, so we can build something to represent a model. Here's a model of a typical wall section. This would be a brick wall section. Along with that, we can have students identify the parts and pieces of this model in this wall section, and we can build these things by assembling them back here in their lab space and utilizing equipment that's over here in the corner, which is our laser cutting systems. So instead of using X-Acto knives and straight edges, what happens is we use a lot of technology where we can draw these things in AutoCAD, bring them over, and then we can cut different pieces and things on our laser support system here. So in all, we kind of look at this class as a building level on up from foundation all the way to roof when we talk about civil engineering architecture. We focus on that outside and the inside of the building. Along with that, we focus on professional skills, and on top of everything else, we try to make sure students are prepared for the next step, which is going off to a four-year school in either an engineering or architecture field. So I'm Andy Beatles. Thank you very much for joining me tonight. I appreciate you being here. Please make sure you go out and apply online at www.applytosictc.com, and we'll see you hopefully next fall.